Hey, what's up, everybody? Ryan Constantino here with Upper State Entertainment, and thanks for joining me on this director's commentary for my latest VFX short film, Aku Aku Lives. I started working on Aku Aku Lives back in February of 2017. It took me a little while to build Aku Aku in a Cinema 4D. I had to figure out, you know, the proportions and you know, how many feathers there were going to be and how to get the feathers to program with dynamics so they would sway back and forth in the wind and when he moved around and all those kinds of things. And then maybe about a month later, I did my first animation test where I zeroed in on how I was going to manipulate all of the eyes and, you know, eyebrows and mouth and all that kind of stuff. After the animation test, I scheduled some shoot days at the beginning of May, which comprised of three separate days. The first day was down here in the parking garage with Liz and Evan, and we shot here, you know, at my front door in my apartment, and then down at the parking garage outside. We did all those scenes, and then the second day was a green screen shoot with both David and Jenny. So I got them on green screen and got that. The third day, Liz and I drove up to Santa Clarita with the help of my mom, and we went to this really beautiful scenic area, which is off of Placerita Canyon Highway, and it's like a hiking hill. And I remember when I was location scouting, I was going down, I looked at some Placerita Canyon Park, and I kept going down the road, and I came across this hiking trail, and it looks so different of a location than anything you see in like the Los Angeles area. It was so very close to nature that I decided I had to shoot there. I dragged Liz out at 4:30 in the morning to try to get there before the sun came up. So when we got there, we set up and I got a couple of shots of the empty, you know, the empty hillside where I was gonna put the ancient ruins. And in order to motion track it, I knew that I might have a problem if it was windy. So I used a couple of tennis balls with a large metal nail just like hammered through it. I just hammered those into the ground so we've got these tracking markers that stay, you know, with the ground. So they proved to be invaluable because I ended up using the location of those to determine like where exactly in 3D space that the ancient ruins would go. The third shooting day, we did all of Liz's lines with Aku Aku and with Luna all on this hillside, and it proved to be very challenging because I had to figure out, you know, what the angle was going to be and what direction they were going to be looking at each other, because originally we shot David on green screen and, you know, Jenny on green screen, and I had to make sure that they were looking to the left and that, you know, Liz was looking to the right, and doing that so that, you know, everyone's eye line is correct, because that's really important, especially for like a CGI element. One of the big challenges that I came across when it came to post-production was rigging the character of Aku Aku and, you know, making sure that his movements coincided with my voiceover actor's face. And in order to do that, I decided that I wanted to motion track his face and then apply that animation directly to Aku Aku in Cinema 4D. That was a challenge because I had never done it before. I figured out a method using Mocha, After Effects, and Cinema 4D Espresso to drive the animation for Aku Aku. And I think this was one of the key components in making Aku's face movement, you know, at least realistic enough to pass for a talking mask. In order to get that motion tracking information, I had a session where David, he did the voiceover for it on camera, and I put green pieces of tape around his mouth and on his face to motion track the movement of his jaw and his lips and everything to apply to Aku Aku in Cinema 4D. And there you have it, a talking Aku Aku. So then after I had motion tracked and set up all of my Cinema 4D files, I ended up going to, you know, my office at work, and, you know, I spent an entire day using the render farm to render out all of these shots. And of course, you know, these are image sequences, so they're tens of thousands of images, being that they're multi-pass images. So I spent, I don't even know, like 10 hours on two separate days just rendering alone. I'm really glad I had access to that, because if I didn't, then my computer here, it would take Like, I don't even know. We'd probably colonized Mars by the time it was done rendering. I was really excited to do the score for this short too, because I thought it would give me a chance to combine lots of different elements from different ethnicities and, you know, instruments and percussion beds from all over the world to create the feeling of what Aku Aku's ancient culture was like. And I didn't want it to just sound like just like South American or Polynesian or Asian or whatever. I wanted it to be a combination of all of those. I wanted it to really kind of hit, you know, hard and tribal and, you know, be unique. There's actually also an Aboriginal sound in there too. You might have been able to pick up the didgeridoo that's in a couple of different places. I spent a lot of time organizing the instruments and the samples in a specific pattern in a 4-4 measure to, you know, give it that kind of rolling tribal feel to it. And what that is it's actually, it's on the first measure and then it's like a 32nd and a 64th beat, and then again the first measure of the next beat. So it's do 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 do. It's got that kind of that rolling feel to it, you know, a bit like kind of like a drum circle that you might hear a bunch of people in Venice Beach, like, you know, sitting around. I had a lot of fun doing this VFX short, but it was very challenging. I had many hours put into the animation and the editing and the compositing and writing the score, and there's a certain sense of pride that I get from seeing one of my favorite video game characters come to life on screen. All right, so that about wraps it up for the director's commentary for Aku Aku Lives. Be sure to like and subscribe to Upper State Entertainment for more cool visual effects videos. Be sure to let me know what kind of tutorials you want to see in the comments below. I'm definitely going to do one for the motion tracking and the character animation, but until next time, catch you later.